Thank you, everybody. New York City, baby!
You guys are great. You guys are great.
My name's Mike. I'm a little short. But I'm not short enough to be cute, not tall enough to be an actual man. I'm in the middle. Women don't find me adorable, but I still can't reach things. My roommate is tall. He has the perfect combination of factors that women love. Non-threatening baby face, shredded body. Women love that. Non-threatening baby face, you could trust me. Shredded body, I'll protect you. I'm not bad looking, but I have the complete opposite thing happening. I have what I like to call ultimate fighter head. But then I have a let's go get frozen yogurt torso, right? Not fat. We're not going to get ice cream. We hit up some froyo with some fruit toppings. Keep it responsible. I'm what they call the department store as a husky fit. I'm at the department store shopping for my husky fit pants. And I know I'm going from husky to fat because my pant size is 36-30. That's how you know you're fat, guys, when your pant size is an improper fraction. I'm equal to 1 1/5 of another human being. That's how I know. Chunky, chunky. So I throw it on 100. That's what I do when I'm insecure. I throw it on 100. Because when you throw it on 100, guys, you go from pudgy to pimp in one motion. Am I right? I think that's a Jay-Z song. From pudgy to pimp. Cashier takes my 100, throws it up to the light like it might be fake. You ever had that? Where a cashier really examines your money? I'm like, first of all, miss, you don't work for the Treasury Department. You're a cashier, you're taking some wrong turns. She determines it's real, hands me back my change. By this time, I'm a little angry, so I take each bill she hands me back, I hold it up to the light. Send her a message, you don't investigate me. I investigate you. I reverse the investigation, everybody. I reverse the investigation. I live in Queens, and my car was stolen recently in Queens where I live. I go to my car, it's not there. I call 911. It took the police 2 hours to get to me, 2 hours. They got there, I'm like, officer, I'm not trying to be a jerk, but in the time it took you to get here, I could have watched 4 episodes of the show Cops. The cops showed up on horses, everybody, to a Grand Theft Auto. Nothing says we do not care about your emergency like cops on horses. So I wrote a Yelp review. Do you guys know that you can Yelp review your local police precinct? You can write a Yelp review like they're a Chili's. So I'm like, cops showed up on horses to my Grand Theft Auto. You guys really need to update your equipment. And I told the cop that. He's like, we put out an APB. I'm like, with what, pigeons? Because obviously you're using a Noah's Ark type system to get my car back. Then the cop was condescending to me, which doesn't make sense because I look like every cop in their precinct. He's like, who do you think stole your car? I'm like, I don't know, officer. Are we using the Socratic method of crime solving? Is this an acting exercise? Are you part of an improv team? My guess is somebody who does not have a car. Perhaps somebody who rides a horse. I reverse the investigation again, guys. I reverse the investigation. Thank you. You guys are beautiful. The worst part is my car was stolen in front of a really good deli in Queens, so cops were showing up, but they were not showing up for my emergency. So I stopped him. I'm like, I called you like 2 hours ago. My car was stolen. He says, we're not street cops. We're counterterrorism. I'm like, I don't know what that means. He says, if you see something, say something. We are those cops. Now, when you went to go get your car, what did you see? I said, my car was gone. So I saw nothing. He says, you only call us if you see something. If you see something, then you can say something. You guys are fantastic. Thank you so much. You guys are beautiful. Thank you.